Some people who have taken psychedelics have described their experience as entering God mode, transcending human perception, or reaching a higher state of consciousness. But what's actually going on inside their brain? To find out, researchers in a recent study gave volunteers intravenous doses of either LSD, psilocybin, or ketamine. Then they did exactly what you'd think they'd do. Lock their tripping volunteers in a loud, claustrophobic machine to scan their brains. The researchers found their brain activity was more random and less integrated, which could explain the randomness of thought that reportedly happens under the influence of psychedelics. They also found that these compounds affected parts of the brain that deal with perception. Essentially, parts of the brain that didn't normally communicate were saying, "Hey there," creating what they called a mixing of senses, sort of like a chemically induced synesthesia. The researchers called this a higher state of consciousness, which coincidentally is what hippies or monks might call this state of mind. But the researchers made a point to say that higher does not mean better or more desirable. Instead, this is just the first time we've measured brain signal diversity that's higher than normal, and that more research is likely needed. Anyone who's ever seen a movie about someone who's been on these drugs understands they're experiencing an altered state of consciousness. But now we have data. Ketamine, psilocybin, and LSD have different pharmacological properties, but in this study, they all produce changes in the neural signal diversity, which is a measure of how complex brain activity is. Ketamine seems to have the widest effect on the brain, while psilocybin affects only a very small section. In the field of neuroscience, these compounds are slowly becoming tools to help researchers find the molecular basis of consciousness. Just like sleep research, psychedelics are a window into the brain at a different state. For example, in a separate study, researchers found the principal nodes in the brain's default mode network, which is an interconnected group of brain structures that creates your sense of self, are disrupted under the influence of psilocybin and LSD. These changes in brain activity are why users often report a temporary loss of self, or ego dissolution. What that means is the brain's central compass, the inner voice you have that drives your behavior, is quieted. The neurons that usually work together lose synchronization, and that is what the researchers think creates an entirely different conscious experience. We still don't know what parts of the brain are responsible for generating consciousness. I mean, the brain is one of the most complex structures in the universe, with over 100 to 500 trillion synapses. We have our work cut out for us. Understanding how brain activity reorients could have therapeutic potential. The default mode network is overactive in people who are prone to depression and pessimistic patterns of thinking, which is why psilocybin is being explored as an antidepressant. And that's the key for these researchers. By seeing how the brain lights up under different drugs and understanding the changes in brain activity, there's hope that these compounds could alleviate hard-to-treat neurological conditions. Psychedelics are a tool to tweak consciousness and gather more data. We have so many pictures of normal brains, but by tweaking things a little and understanding what's happening, we get better insight into how the brain does this amazing thing that it's doing for you and me right now. Special thanks to our sponsor, domain.com. When you buy a domain name from domain.com, you're taking the first steps in creating an identity and vision for your brand. No domain extension will help you tell your story like a .com or .net domain name. Get 50% off domain.com's already affordable domain names and web hosting when you use coupon code SEEKER at checkout. Ketamine, LSD, and psilocybin are known to cause hallucinations, but you don't need drugs to have a good time, if having a good time means seeing crazy imagined things. Trace and I talk about hallucinations here. So, what do you think about the potential for using these chemicals to understand how consciousness forms? Let us know in the comments, subscribe for more, and I will see you next time on Seeker.